Well, hello once again. I want to show you today my little project I've been working on. It's PlayStation 1 Slim version. What I did was I gutted it out completely, put a Rasberry Pi 3 in there. That way I could play ROMs using the PlayStation 1 Slim as a case, basically. And I also soldered the original DualShock 2 controller right here to that using an adapter I had to buy off Amazon. Let's open it up and take a glance at it real quick. You know, it's nothing neat or anything because I had to cram it all in there, and the cutout is terrible, but this was just a trial version and so I did a rough job on it, but I'm gonna get another one and do a much cleaner job of it. And there, as you can see, the Raspberry Pi 3. I cut up the main board. I did leave the power right here. This is from the PlayStation 1 Slim. I used it. I had to solder some wires to a, I think you might can see it in the corner there, be kind of hard, but that's a, right there is a DC buck converter or step down. Takes 12 volts and a sort of little adjustment screw. You can go down to 5 volts or whatever you need for the Raspberry Pi. And this is for the controller, this wire here and all of these. This is what I had to solder into the controller to get it working with the original controller. Player 2 works as well. I just don't have a controller for it right now. My other one broke. So, let's take a look around the back before we get to the software version. This is the hardware. Like I said, the power. I'm just using a 12-volt power supply that I already had. You can plug it. You can unplug it and plug it in, just like normal. The only thing is, with the HDMI, I had to use the HDMI extension off Amazon, and it just plugs into there. Female here to a male going to my TV. And this is going to the Raspberry Pi. I tried to mount it here, but with the cord being so thick and crawling it up right here, it was really hard to get the case on. So I'm gonna buy a different HDMI cable, smaller and thinner, and could probably get it that can mount this. So all you do is plug the HDMI to the back of the PlayStation like that. And so when you unplug it, it'll be just perfect. Now just one cord hangs out, which is okay. I'm using, for a software version, I'm using Madlittlepixel's PlayStation Pi. Here it is. Let me go ahead and pick up the controller. So I'm using the controller here. And as you can see, once I click it, it moves the game selection. Right now we're in a track mode. Metal Slug, pretty good game. So I got it on mute. I'll take it off for a second. Alright, as you can see, here's some of the games. NFL Blitz. And it includes the disc image, the case image, a logo, video preview, and all that. And then, you know, thanks to Madlittlepixel for putting this image together. Saved me a lot of time. Let's see. All kind of different games, and they do work. Also, oh, we have one thing on the hardware, the power button. I installed an LED, but you can't see it. I guess I didn't get a bright enough LED. Let's focus. But the power button does work. I will shut it down doing that. There is 269 games on here. I'm gonna add a few more of my favorites that's not on this image, but I could do that pretty easily. And there it is. PlayStation Pi and a PlayStation Slim using the original controllers. Now let's just hit the power button and see how it loads the script. It's pretty sweet. Alright, thanks for watching.